Hola y bienvenidos a Eagle TV. Hoy vamos a entrevistar una de las maestras de Sherman Oaks. Aquí estamos con la maestra Álvarez de quinto grado. Hola maestra Álvarez,
hola,
bienvenidos
hola.
A Eagle TV.
Muchas gracias, gusto en estar aquí.
¿Nos puedes decir un poquito sobre tu niñez?
Sí, yo nací, soy nacida en México, en Michoacán, Uruapan, Michoacán. Llegué a los Estados Unidos cuando yo estaba, pues, creo que en tercer grado. Llegué al estado de Washington, donde no había escuela bilingües y nadie hablaba en inglés. Y pues yo puro español y se me hizo muy difícil, pero aquí estoy, muy orgullosa de estar aquí.
Cuando eras niña, ¿dónde vivía tu familia?
Vivimos en varios lados en México, en Jalisco, en Michoacán, inclusive en el DF, y después nos mudamos acá a los Estados Unidos. Llegamos al estado de Washington, en Vancouver, Washington. Después nos mudamos aquí a California. Llegamos a vivir en San José, en Sunnyvale, en Fremont, y ahora ya llegamos a San José.
¿Tenías hermanos o hermanas?
Tengo una hermana menor.
¿Cuántos años has estado en Sherman Oaks?
En Sherman Oaks tengo 8 años trabajando. He enseñado quinto y tercero.
¿Cómo ha cambiado Sherman Oaks?
Híjole, ha cambiado bastante. Primeramente, el currículo, lo que enseñamos, es diferente. Teníamos otras reglas, pero poco a poquito las cosas han estado mejorando y hemos aprendido de todo lo que hacemos con los estudiantes y cada año hacemos las cosas mejor aquí.
¿Cómo te gusta trabajar como maestra de quinto grado?
Me encanta, creo que es mi grado favorito. Creo que también me gusta el cuarto, el tercero, pero quinto me gusta mucho por el currículo, la matemática, la ciencia, la historia. Son temas que a mí me encantan.
¿Cuál es la parte más te gusta de ser maestra?
La parte que más me gusta es de conocer a los estudiantes fuera de su hogar, como persona, como estudiante, ayudarlos a mejorar y ver a los estudiantes aprender algo nuevo. Cuando aprenden algo nuevo y se les hace más fácil, veo un cambio y veo que van madurando cada vez que están aprendiendo.
¿Cuándo te diste cuenta que querías ser una maestra?
Fíjate que yo fui a la Universidad Estatal de San José y yo estaba estudiando biología. Me encanta la biología, pero no me gustaba estar en los laboratorios encerrada. Entonces, al mismo tiempo estaba trabajando para la Universidad Estatal de San José y ahí me dieron un trabajo de trabajar con estudiantes y es donde aprendí que me gustaba tratar con los estudiantes, con los niños.
¿Querías tener otra profesión antes de ser maestra?
Varias. Me encantaría haber sido una conductora de carros rápidos, de carrera, carros de carrera. Natación, también olimpiada a lo mejor. Pero por eso decidí ser maestra, porque en la escuela hacemos un poquito de todo.
¿Hay un lugar que has querido visitar?
Sí, yo quiero visitar a Grecia porque estudiamos mucha historia y Grecia es un lugar donde tiene mucha historia griega.
Uh-huh. ¿Hay algo interesante sobre ti que nos puedes decir?
Algo interesante sobre mí, que me gusta comer mucho. A mí me encanta comer y me encanta tener mucha energía, pues, entonces para tener mucha energía, pues uno tiene que comer mucho. Entonces eso es interesante de mí.
¿Hay algo que recomendarías para una persona que sueña ser maestra o maestra?
Para una persona que quiere ser maestro o maestra, yo les recomendaría estudiar de todo. Un maestro, una maestra enseña de todo. No es nada más matemáticas, no es nada más ciencia. Tratamos muchos temas. Y inclusive usamos la tecnología, usamos diferentes tipos de textos, aprendemos de todo. Entonces yo les recomiendo que sean una persona que les interese no solamente un tema, sino varios temas.
Muchas gracias por ser nuestra maestra de quinto grado y gracias por estar aquí con nosotros.
Claro, gracias a ustedes por tenerme aquí.
Y para ustedes, viéndonos en casa, gracias por mirar Eagle TV, recuerda, ¡vamos Águilas!
I'm Salamis.
And I'm Jennifer.
And welcome to Sherman Oaks Eagle TV. Today we are going to learn about Girls on the Run, a new program here at Sherman Oaks School that focuses on healthy minds and healthy lives for girls. We will interview the instructors of students in the program.
And now we are here with some of the students in the program.
Please tell us why you decided to join the Girls on the Run.
This is my second year in Girls on the Run, and on the first year I decided to join because I heard that it was a really good empowerment program.
What do you like most about the class?
The thing that I like most about the class is that we can express each other's feelings and we feel like good around each other.
Are you excited about the 5K run coming?
Yeah, I'm excited about it.
Please tell us why you decided to join Girls on the Run.
I didn't really like running, so I'm trying to get better at it.
What do you like most about the class?
I like that I'm able to, that I feel like I can basically share anything with the girls.
Thank you for sharing.
And now we are here with Ms. Vizan, an instructor from the program. Hi, Ms. Vizan.
Hi, how are both of you?
Good. How are you doing?
I'm good, thank you very much.
First, can you please tell us what Girls on the Run and what do you do on the program?
Girls on the Run is a program that's been around for about 15 years. It's about girls not only running, but it's teaching them about leadership, positive discipline, self-esteem, and it's about girl power.
What do you like the most about Girls on the Run?
I like the activities that we do as far as self-esteem and bullying and peer pressure, and the running is fun. We get to have fun and be silly.
How did Girls on the Run get started at Sherman Oaks?
Last year, Maestra Morales and I both heard about it, and so we wanted to bring it to this school. So we actually just filled out an application, and we started it.
Can you please tell us what the girls do in the program?
The girls, when they first come in, we do about 30 minutes of activities, where each week is focused on a different activity. Today was gratitude. So we talk about gratitude and what that means. We have little activities, and then afterwards we do some running. Because at the end of the season, all the girls will do a 5K, which is 3.1 miles, at Vasona Park. So we're working up to a 5K run.
Thank you for spending time with us.
Well, thank you very much for the interview.
We appreciate that you have brought this program to Sherman Oaks.
Well, thank you. And this is our Girls on the Run team.
And for those of you at home, thank you for watching Eagle TV. Go Eagles!
Go Eagles!
Hi, and welcome to Eagle TV. My name is Lucas. Today, we are visiting the Tech Museum of Innovation in downtown San Jose. The Tech is a nonprofit museum that is a celebration of technology and features many exhibits and gadgets and gizmos to learn and have fun with. Today, the fifth grade students from Sherman Oaks Elementary School are on a field trip to the Tech. And Eagle TV will be showing you just how awesome the tech is by showing you some exhibits and talking about people here. Let's check it out.
And now we're here with the employee. Hi, can you please tell us your name and what do you and what you do here at the tech?
My name is Kathy and I am with the guest services department.
What is your favorite exhibit at the tech?
Well, one of my favorite exhibits here at the Tech Museum will be the Reactable exhibit, which is upstairs at the Tech Silicon Valley exhibit. It's basically an exhibit where you get to play with different blocks, and it makes out of those blocks, it makes different music rhythms in which you get to listen to and switch those rhythms up.
What is the current Star Wars exhibit at the Tech all about?
The Star Wars exhibit here at the Tech Museum is definitely an exhibit which has different props and costumes from the actual Star Wars movie. It's a little mini museum where you get to walk through, explore, take a look at all the characters and costumes from the movie inside.
Can you please tell us about the IMAX that is here at the Tech?
The IMAX theater here at the Tech Museum plays educational IMAX, and generally it's all generally run for 45 minutes every day. We have different documentaries definitely about the ocean or space, and then we have our newest one which is called Islands of the Lemurs coming in April.
Are there any special programs or competitions that take place at the Tech that are meant for students?
One of the main programs that we run through each year, which is in April, is called our Tech Challenge. Tech Challenge is basically one of a kind science fair that we host at the Tech Museum. We basically open the program out to all the students in middle school and high school. And each year there's different types of topics that you get to reinnovate different inventions to help better either different systems within the world.
How do you enjoy working at the Tech and how long have you been here for?
I definitely enjoy working at the Tech Museum. I've been here for roughly 4.5 years with the guest services department. Each day we run through different types of people, cultures that visit the Tech Museum, especially kids like you guys who comes on field trips, and we definitely get to interact with all the kids and enjoy that kind of experience.
And for anyone wanting to visit the Tech, how would they get some more information about museum hours and ticket prices?
Guests can definitely stop by the ticket counter to learn more about pricings and exhibits that we have in the Tech Museum, or you can stop by at our website, which is www.thetech.org.
Well, thank you for your time. We really enjoy visiting the Tech.
Thank you.
Hi, and now we are here with a volunteer from the Tech Museum. Hi, can you please tell us your name and what do you do here at the Tech?
Hello, my name is Jackie Zucker, and I'm an exhibit explainer here at the Tech.
What is your favorite exhibit at the Tech?
Oh, that's a hard question because I like many of the exhibits here, but I think that one of my favorite ones, oh my goodness, it's the wet lab. At the wet lab, we do experiments.
Why do people volunteer here at the Tech Museum, or what made you decide to work here?
Well, I had some free time available and I wanted to give back because I've worked as a nurse for quite a few years, but I really enjoyed working here at the Tech as a volunteer.
How do you enjoy working at the Tech, and how long have you been here for?
I really like working here. Everybody here is really nice. I enjoy the interactions with all of you. And I've been here for 2 years.
Well, thank you for your time. We really enjoy visiting the Tech.
Oh, thank you. Thanks for coming.
Okay, how do you guys like your trip to the Tech Museum today?
It was fun.
It was fun. Very fun.
What was your favorite exhibit of the Tech?
It was this one. You get say something and your voice changes.
pretty cool.
What's your favorite exhibition?
Mine was the, I think it was like the Marching Sisters. Like when you move your hands, you can be doing the beat.
What was yours?
I liked this one because you get to change your voice, and it's really funny depending on what you say.
And what was yours, Malachi?
I like this one because it's funny, it's cool, and then I like that one because it senses you and it looks cool, and I like the other one with the lights because it's fun too.
Well, thank you for spending your time with us. Hi, this is Lucas from Ego TV, and I'm standing in front of the earthquake simulator. The earthquake simulator is showing you is simulating an earthquake. Over there, you see that over there, it's simulating the earthquake of Loma Prieta, and it shakes you. You get to build block houses and have fun and enjoy the ride of the earthquake simulator.
Hello, this is Ego TV, and today we are interviewing Maestra, and we are about to leave the Tech Museum. Hola. ¿Quién pagó para la expedición al Museo de Tech hoy?
Hola, gracias al grupo PTC y todos los la recaudación que hemos hecho durante este año pudimos pagar este viaje.
Gracias. ¿Qué fue la razón que tú y la maestra más que querías traernos aquí?
Bueno, nosotros vinimos porque estaban ofreciendo un IMAX de Lewis y Clark, la expedición, y como acabamos de concluir ese libro, esa novela, el libro de capítulo, decidimos que iba a ser una buena conexión, y creo que la mayoría o todos los estudiantes hicieron esas conexiones porque yo los estaba viendo y los estaba escuchando, y espero llegar al salón para tener más una conversación sobre lo que vimos y lo que estudiamos en el salón.
¿Qué fue tu parte favorita?
Definitivamente la programación y también todo lo que están viendo acá afuera. Los estudiantes están trabajando con sus manos, están leyendo, están participando en grupo, están viendo varias exhibiciones y creo que se están divirtiendo bastante.
Bueno, gracias por tomar tu tiempo para contestar nuestras preguntas.
Gracias a ustedes.
That wraps it up for our trip to the Tech today. We hope you enjoyed learning about this awesome museum. It is a great place to visit if you had not been here before. From Ego TV, vamos Águilas, and we will see you soon. Thank you.
start, we will start the grand raffle. Good luck to all who have a ticket, and thank you very much for your support.
Y el primer premio, el gran premio, first place, grand prize.
Y el ganador de primer lugar es Anthony Ruiz.
You're ready for middle school. ¿Estás listo para middle school?
Gracias por el apoyo al sexto grado y a todos quienes hicieron posible este gran evento.
Let's give a big round of applause to all the performers. They did a fabulous job. Please, another round of applause.
How did you feel about this wonderful night?
Oh, I'm going to use yours. I thought this event was fantastic. All the sixth graders did an amazing job serving the community. It was so wonderful to come and help out at this sixth grade event. And I loved the talent and the food was great. So yes, it was successful. Thank you.
How did you feel about this fun night?
I think it was a great night. That's okay. I thought it was great to see all the support for sixth grade, and I'm excited that they've been able to raise money to go to Yosemite, and I think it's amazing that so many people came out to support that.
Did you have fun while you were here?
Yes, I had a great time. I enjoyed all the enthusiasm of all of our audience members and performers.
Thank you for interviewing with us.
Thank you.
Did you have fun tonight?
I had a great time. A lot of hard work, but a great time.
Why were the audience here?
The audience were here because we were having a pasta dinner fundraiser. The sixth graders were trying to go to Yosemite, and so they're trying to collect money and fundraise money. So we had this event, and so everybody was here to have dinner and enjoy some entertainment and some performers and some singers, and that's why we all got together for this event.
Thank you.
Thank you.